Hello, Patrick Walchuk here. You know, lately there's been a lot of debate about a housing crisis in Canada and a housing crisis in Ottawa, but maybe buying a house is not the right thing to do. Maybe it's just not right for you, even if you can afford it. So what I'm saying is don't buy real estate if it's not right for you. So let's look at the reasons maybe why you should not buy real estate. So you have an initial investment. The average price of a house, a freehold property in Ottawa right now, is about $707,000. Now, let's assume you want to buy it and not have to pay CMHC fees. So you use a 20% down payment. And so you're paying $141,000. Now, when you buy a house, you have closing costs. And that's about 1.75% of the value of the house. And those closing costs pay for legal fees, land transfer tax, that kind of thing. So just to purchase the property, you're all in for about $154,000. Now, in your first year, you're going to have costs like every homeowner. You got property tax, you got insurance, heat, hydro, water, sewer, maintenance, and just the interest on your mortgage payments, not the principal that you're paying down, just the interest alone in our example is almost $30,000. So just your holding costs for that first year are over $41,000. Now, you take our initial upfront purchase costs that we talked about, the holding costs of almost $42,000. So now you're all in for $195,000 at the end of your first year. And realistically, that doesn't even include any renovations you're going to do, any remodeling, landscaping, drapery, carpets, new appliances, furniture, etc. And let's be honest, you are going to be buying a lot of these things. You could well be into the property for $225,000. Okay, now what if you didn't buy it? Let's say you can afford to buy it, but you want a different lifestyle, you want a more carefree lifestyle, so you're going to rent. So if you took that first year cost of about $195,000 and you invested it, you put it in the stock market, you buy ETFs, whatever it is that you invest in, and you make 6%, which is very reasonable, that $195,000 will put almost an extra $12,000 in your pocket. So at the end of year one, you could have almost $207,000 more than if you had bought the house. Now, granted, here's some things that won't happen. You won't gain in the annual property appreciation, and that is a fact. You won't have your own home, perhaps more of a psychological thing, you know, that I got to own my own house. And you won't have that part of it. And the other thing is, you will have to pay rent. You've got to live somewhere if you're getting tired of living in your parents' basement. And let's say you're going to pay $2,400 a month in rent to find something suitable for yourself. So you're going to be out about $28,000, okay? Now, here's some things that you really need to be honest about with yourself. Home ownership is expensive, as I just outlined to you, so it's not for everyone. Don't let other people talk you into a financial commitment that you're simply not ready for. You could buy a house and be just bloody miserable. Financial stress is supposedly the number one factor in marital breakups and divorce. You could be happier living in a rental property. You have more money in your pocket, more personal time, and you've got less stress. So again, buying real estate may not be for you.